So let's run through game day. We hear these questions all the time. You know, what do you eat on game day? What do you eat on game day? What do you eat on game day? Really, you should have that planned. You should be able to tell somebody rather than showing up to the Home Depot Center with a not a clue, and you're going upstairs to buy food from the concession stand. You laugh, but it happens, right? We've seen people in the basement eating that stuff, okay? We should have a very good idea of what supplies you're going to need for game day so that you operate the best, the most effectively. Somebody that shows up with either a cooler or shopping bags, you know they've got their plan. All right, so what's that look like? Okay, well, we've got a single day competition planned. There's four workouts. Workout number one goes down at 0900. And I'm just gonna describe it. Actually, let me just write all these down. Workout number two is a skill test, and it goes down at 12 o'clock. Workout number three, 1:30. And it's actually a floater workout. Workout number four, final workout of the day, goes down at 1900. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna see how this goes. Now, again, remember, this is the three plus workouts per day, 25 blocks. So right away, we know that's where we need to go. Workout number one, I'm just gonna describe it real fast. 50 ground overhead with 45 pound plate, 75 push-ups, hand release, 100 air squats, 1200 meter run, hill run with 45 pound plate. Demanding? Absolutely. Very demanding. Skill test. I'll give you what the skill test is. 3 minutes max weight pull up. 2 minutes max distance handstand walk. 1 minute double unders. Difficult? Demanding. Not as demanding, right? As far as the energy expenditure, we're not gonna see anywhere near the same from that one to this one, okay? Now with that said, WOD 3. This is super easy. 3 minutes, burpees over a wall, 6-foot wall. Yeah. Super glycolytic, super hard, right? How fast can you go? How long can you maintain? That sort of workout. All right. Workout number four, final workout. Pretty cool little ladder. 3 fat bar deadlifts, 205. Okay, there you go. 145. 1 15-foot rope climb. 6 deadlift, 1 rope climb. 9 deadlift, 1 rope climb. You get the idea. And that's AMRAP, 9 minutes. Okay, simple enough. Demanding? Heck yeah, heck yeah, heck yeah. Now here's how we're gonna base this. We've got 25 blocks a day that we know we need to take in order to perform our best during this day. Okay? Obviously, you're not gonna go into workout number one without eating something. So 0700, start off with a breakfast. And I'm gonna give you some specific examples here. If we're gonna break it down for our athlete that normally eats 18 blocks a day, we adjust the volume to 25 blocks. The best way to kind of break this thing up is we've got a 4-block meal. It could be something as simple as 4 eggs, 4 cups of strawberries and 12 almonds. 4 blocks, boom. You don't wanna have it fall too close to within that workout number one. You guys got an idea why? besides the volume in your stomach, and that's gonna suck. Also, if you eat too closely to a workout, your insulin spikes and your blood sugar drops. So you risk going hypoglycemic during the workout. So you wanna make sure that your blood sugar is stabilized well before workout one. An hour is a good general figure for all of us. Eat 1 hour pre-workout, okay? Now, yes, you could probably sneak in, if it's a shorter workout, sneak some carbohydrate in just to elevate those blood sugar levels just beforehand. But again, you need to test that out. This will work. 0900 goes down. We do the workout. It takes 13 minutes. Next thing that's going to happen, post-workout. So we're looking at, let's call it 0930, PWO, post-workout. And what did we say our post-workout was? 3 protein for this athlete, 4 carbohydrate. Whey, coconut juice. Shake it up, drink it. Boom. Noon rolls around. Now you look at this and you say, well, it's not a very demanding workout. I had a meal at 9:30. I'm probably going to be good for the skill test. It's not necessary to have a very high blood sugar level or anything like that for that. We complete this thing, finish shaking your shoulders a little bit. You're like, oof, not too bad though. 12:30, lunch. Not necessary to do a post-workout meal. We could totally stomach a meal after that. 4 blocks. Make sense? So we've got, so far we're at 3 blocks here, 4 blocks here, 4 blocks here. 1:30 rolls around. We definitely had time to digest that for that workout number 3. 3 minutes of burpees over a 6-foot wall. Gonna need a post-workout after that. So we're gonna do 3 protein, 4 carbs. That's roughly a 3-block meal. Now, a long time passes between that one, which was roughly 2 o'clock. So 1400 to 1900. So we're going to have a meal at some point. And I'd say probably opportune would be somewhere right around 6 o'clock, maybe even a little earlier. And we're going to have dinner. 4-block meal. Now, after that dinner, we've digested, we've got a workout that's gonna last 9 minutes, super demanding. Follow it up, because guys, remember, we're expected to train after this day with a post-workout meal at about 19:30. And again, 3 protein, 4 carb. Now, if we add these all together, we've got 4, 4, 4, so there's 12. We've got 3, 3, and 3, that's 9. So we're at 21 blocks. We've got time for a bedtime snack to fill out the rest of those 25 blocks. Calorically, we should be there. That should take care of us for the rest of the day, and we shouldn't feel any nutritional deficits for the next training day. Does everybody get that?
When you fill out your calories in the bedtime snack, would you, for example, take away some carbs and add fat so that you add up to your 25 perfectly? Do you know what I mean? Because you didn't have that post-workout, and those were uneven protein carbohydrate?
Yeah, that's a great question. So because we had an increased level of carbohydrate throughout the day without any fat, could you take then and kind of backlog the fat into your last bedtime snack, absolutely, so that we could follow that baseline, or we could just call it a baseline for that snack, and that'd be fine, and just have the 3, 3, and 3. Boom. We're even for a 25-block day. Okay? Now, for my athletes, I've seen this work time and time again, and they are religious about following this prescription. And very rarely do you see them walking around like zombies before a workout 4. I don't want nutrition to be the limiting factor for me or for my athletes. And by following a zone block prescription like this, it's very easy to have them stick to it and see them perform well and be the limiting factor, not be their energy levels due to nutrition, but due to their fatigue and to their, you know, muscular fatigue, the volume for the day, were they prepared for it? Nutrition is a big part of the game day stuff.